Money from the CARES Act has been distributed to many small businesses across the country, and while it's helped, some owners say it's time to get back to work. I recently spoke with Ben Huhman, owner of the Grand Cafe and High-Rise Bakery in Jefferson City, Missouri. They've been delivery and pickup only since mid-March, but tomorrow will open their doors and get back to business as cautiously as they can.
We obviously want to keep the social distancing guidelines of 6 feet apart. So we've taken tables out of both dining rooms in order to keep that space. The other guidelines were things like, you know, just limiting our capacity. We're probably looking at less than half of our capacity. We're gonna try to put a few extra tables outside, and then we will all be wearing protective equipment, masks and gloves while we're serving. You know, we're not gonna require patrons to come in with those on, but we will be wearing those.
Ben, if you could describe your town a little bit and the economic impact that's been felt there.
I don't know the exact population of our town. It's in that 30 to 40,000 person range. It's not been good. There are a few, I know of a few people that do the same type of thing that I do that won't be reopening their doors. Some of them completely closed down. My businesses, I would say we've been doing 25% of our normal revenues.
And when you do open your doors on Monday, what are you expecting to see? Do you expect customers to come in, sit down, order a meal, and enjoy it by dining in?
We do. We've actually got some reservations, honestly. People want to get out. They want to get back to normal. It's a little bit different in our small town. We haven't seen the number of cases that they have in places like New York or Seattle, places like that.
And how do your staff feel? Are they all coming back?
For the most part, everybody, my main staff has been with me through the whole thing. We've been offering curbside and delivery and things like that. I guess everybody's a little apprehensive, but all that's really done is made us make sure that everybody is comfortable and that our employees are comfortable as well.
And why have you made the decision to open up on Monday? You don't have to. You could wait a little bit longer. Why now?
It's kind of a necessity. We can't sustain like this forever. In fact, I'd say we probably wouldn't want to try to do this for very much longer. It's tough, you know. It's a tough decision. We don't take it lightly for sure. We need to be open so that we can generate revenue, so that we can pay our taxes, so that the state can turn around and pay taxes to the federal government. I mean, that's how our economy works. We're kind of dipping our toe in and seeing where it takes us.
What do you say to critics that say you're just opening up too soon? You should wait longer.
Well, there's an argument there. There's an argument both ways. Our little town, we're spread out as it is, and we don't have the number of cases around us. So it makes us feel a little bit more comfortable. And there is a want from the public. People are ready to get out and get somewhat back to normal.
Ben Huhman, thank you so much and good luck.
Thank you.